In this video, we will try to understand new bio-inspired optimization algorithm that mimics the behavior of cells in the ocean. You can see the list of topics that we will cover in this video. First, we'll start with what is this algorithm all about, how it is working, main inspiration behind this algorithm, different steps used in this algorithm, mathematical model, parameter settings. Then we have application, advantages and disadvantages of this algorithm. And we will discuss a real life application, how we can use this algorithm for optimizing routing in sensor networks like WWAN or large wireless sensor networks. So first we'll start with what is this algorithm all about, how it is working. First, you can see here it is a bio-inspired optimization algorithm introduced in year 2017. And this algorithm is based on the behavior of a living organism, that is a SELP, which are small jellyfish-like marine animals that move in groups, or we can say they move in swarm in the ocean, and they form long chains and follow each other with the leader at the front exploring new path and the other following the leader in a coordinated way. So in simple words, we can say this algorithm mimics how these cells move and work together to find food or navigate in the ocean. So in real life, cells are using this behavior to find out foods, avoid from predator and navigate in the ocean. This algorithm will mimic the cell's behavior to solve complex problems like finding the best route in a network or optimizing something in a system. Done. So first we will start with algorithm inspiration, that is the self-swarming behavior. So first we will discuss about cells in real life, different strategies they use for the survival and their behavior, because this algorithm structure is modeled based on the cell's behavior. So first we will try to understand cell's behavior in real life so that we can easily understand how this algorithm is working. So algorithm inspiration we have, that is the swarming behavior of cells. So cells are marine organisms that swim in chain-like formation, and about cells you can see they are transparent barrel-shaped marine organisms that drift in the ocean current. And how they move, you can see here they move by shrinking, which moves them forward and form dense chain that help in coordinated movement. So here you can see they form dense chain. Because of this, they are able to survive in the large and dynamic environments, and which also help them to avoid predator and identify food sources. Now you can see cell swarm algorithm structure. So this algorithm is modeled based on the self synchronized behavior and chain-like movement. Then, so this algorithm simulates self chain-like movement and different synchronized behavior they use for the survival in the real life. Similarly, how self navigate the ocean, this algorithm uses group intelligence to explore and exploit the search space. So in this algorithm, cells are modeled as the search agents. As in the population-based algorithm, we start with the random population in the search space. Initially, we randomly initialize the population. So here, we will initialize the cell population randomly in the search space. Done. That we will use to perform exploration and exploitation phases. So in this population, each cell is a candidate solution that is exploring the search space to find out the optimal or near optimal solution. Done. So this algorithm models their coordinated movement to solve different optimization problems. Now next we will try to understand how this algorithm works. So first we have cell chain formation. Initially we have the population of cell. Initially we will divide the population into two groups. We have leader and follower. Leader self will guide the movement toward the target, or we can say it will guide the movement towards the optimal solution. Next we have follower. Followers will adjust their position based on the self ahead of them and forming a chain-like structure that explore the search space. So here you can see different steps that we will use in this algorithm. First, we will initialize the population for n agents in the search space. After that, we'll start the main loop here, calculate the fitness value for each search agent. Search agent we have here, self. Then we will identify the best search agent among all, update parameter C1. Then for each self, we will update the position of leader. We will update leader position and follower position. Then we will check the boundary, whether the updated solutions are within the bounds or not. Repeat the loop until the stopping condition is met. And once the stopping condition is met, we will stop and display the best solution found. Done. Now you can see the mathematical models for the movement of leader and followers. First, we have leader's movement. So the position of leader is updated with respect to the best solution found so far. That is similar to exploitation in the optimization. Done. So leader moves toward the target. Done. Here we have target as the food source. F is here the food source. So we will consider food source as the best solution. So that leader will move toward the target, and using this equation we can update the leader position. Here this is the new position of the leader in the jth dimension. Fj, that is the position of food source in the jth dimension, or we can say this is the best solution in the jth dimension. Then we have lower bound and upper bound in the jth dimension. Then we have three random numbers, c1, c2, c3. They are used to guide the exploration and exploitation processes. After that, we have the mathematical equation for the follower movement. So followers will update their position based on the self ahead of them. So as they form dense chain, so we'll update the follower position based on the self ahead of them. Here you can see this is the position of ith follower in the jth dimension, and this is the position of the previous self, that is the leader. The previous self can be the leader or the another follower. So here we have two phases. So in the exploration phase, so in the early stages, the random number in SSA increase the cells to explore the search space widely. Search agents will explore new areas. But as the iteration proceed, cells will focus more on fine-tuning their position around the best found solution. Then, so leader will guide the swarm toward the optimal solution, and then followers will follow the leader and accordingly adjust their position. So the goal is to move all the cells closer to the optimal solution by mimicking how cells adjust their position in chain-like formation. Done. Follower movement, we are using this formula, this simple formula that will ensure that each follower's cell stay close to the one ahead and creating a chain-like formation. Followers are also refining their position by abrasing their current position with those ahead of them. So then we have different coefficients. C1, you can see here this coefficient C1, it is a time varying coefficient, and the value for this coefficient will decrease as the number of iteration increase. You can see this is the current iteration and this is the maximum number of iteration. So this formula is used here to ensure that C1 start near value 2 at the beginning of the search, and the value for C1 is gradually decreasing to 0. That is focusing on exploitation as the algorithm converges. In optimization algorithm, it's important to make a proper balance between both exploration and exploitation phases. In exploration, we explore new areas of the search space, finding diverse solution. In exploitation, we refine the solution around the promising area. So it is important to maintain a balance between both exploration and exploitation phases. So in this algorithm, in the early iteration, the leader self will explore the search space more widely with a large movement and increased by the coefficient C2 and C3. So as the C1 value decreases over time, leader movement become more focused and the follower selves refine their position based on the selves ahead of them. So this is gradually converging on the optimal solution. Now step by step you can see, first you will define the population size n, check the number of dimension, maximum number of iteration. Then we will initialize the position for all n cells randomly within the search space. After that, we will evaluate the fitness of each cell based on the objective function. So you can use the objective function to compute the fitness value for each cell in the current population. After that, we will update the leader and the follower position using mathematical model. So we'll identify the best self in the current population. Then we will update the leader position. After that, we will update the follower. So for each follower, we will update the position based on the position of the self ahead. After that, we will perform boundary check. So we'll ensure that all the cells remain within the defined bounds. If any cells exceed the bounds, then we will reinitialize this position within the limits. After that, we will update the best solution. So if any cell fitness value improved, then we will consider that as the best solution. Done. Here we will update the best fitness value. After that, we will repeat all the steps until maximum iteration. As the maximum iteration reach, it will return us a solution. Now we have different advantages. This algorithm is easy to understand, implement. This algorithm uses simple mathematical model to just update the follower position, leader position, and then repeat the steps. In this algorithm, we have proper balance between both exploration and exploitation phases. We have flexibility, and also we have few control parameters. Next, we have disadvantages, like for the complex optimization problem, there is a risk of premature convergence. As you can see, we have different disadvantages. So for that, we can create a hybrid approach. We can combine this algorithm with another algorithm for better quality solution. So you can see this algorithm has simple structure. So algorithm inspiration is the cell swarming behavior. Population structure, we have leader, two groups. A population is divided into two groups. We have leaders and follower. Then the exploration strategy is performed using the stochastic leader movement. Exploitation strategy that is performed using follower following the leaders. And we have low parameter complexity, and this algorithm is easy to implement. Now we have different application where we can use this algorithm. So we can use this algorithm to solve variety of optimization problems in different fields, in engineering design, for optimizing different mechanical structure, electrical circuit. In image processing, we can use this algorithm to improve the feature selection, feature extraction in the image. We can use this for the task scheduling. We can apply this algorithm to schedule task in computational grid, optimizing resource allocation. For route optimization, we can use this in transportation to find out the most efficient route. So next, we will discuss a real life application, how we can use this algorithm for optimizing routing in sensor networks like WVAN or large wireless sensor networks. And we want to optimize the routing in sensor network. Goal is to find out the best routing path that reduces delay and save energy. So here we want to find out the best path, that is the best routing path that reduces the communication delay and minimize the energy uses of the sensor nodes. First, we will define the routing problem. So here in the sensor network, we have sensor nodes and the routes, or we can say path. Sensor nodes collect the data and send it to a central base station, for example, a medical monitor in WVAN. Then we have different paths. So data travel through one sensor to the next, eventually reaching the sink, or we can say the station. So here data is traveling from one sensor to the next. So some routes are faster while other save energy. So we need to find out the best path that minimize the communication delay and also minimize the energy consumption. So our goal is here to find out the best path that minimize the communication delay and also minimize the energy consumption. So minimize communication delay means how fast the data reaches the sink and plus how much battery each sensor uses. We represent here the network as search space, and each possible path from sensor node to sink is a potential solution, because we want to find out the possible path, best possible path that minimize delay and also minimize energy consumption. So here each path from the sensor node to the sink is a potential solution. So this algorithm will explore this path to find out the best one. Here we have nodes as sensor, edges, that is the connection between sensors, done, which are path or routes. So first we'll initialize the population, that is the population of the cell. We'll consider each cell in this algorithm population as a possible routing path in the network. Initially, we will generate different random path from sensor node to the sink. So in the population-based algorithm, we initialize the population randomly, and we will consider these initial paths as our initial solution. Next, we will define the objective function. We use objective function to measure the quality of the solution. We define the objective function to measure how good or bad each routing path is based on communication delay and energy consumption. Communication delay means we will check the routing path time, that how much time it take, that how much time it take for data to travel along the path, and total battery power. So for each path, we will measure the time that it take for data to travel along the path and total battery power used along the path. So we have this simple objective function. Here you can see delay x. X is the path. So it means how long it takes for data to travel from sensor node to the sink using path x. Second, we have energy x. X is again here the path. The total energy used along the path. Done. Alpha and beta, we have the weights that we can adjust according to our needs. They are used here to prioritize delay or energy consumption. Done. After that, we will update the leader and the follower. So we'll use the mathematical models. So first we have leader self. So here self is the routing path. So self that perform best become the leader, means the path having lowest delay and energy is considered as the best path or the leader. Done. So leader will explore new path in the network and trying to find out better routes. Using this mathematical equation, we will update the position in the search space. Then we have follower self. So the other follower self means the other path. They will adjust themselves according to the follower. So they will follow the leader. So followers will use this equation to define their position and adjust their routing path based on the leader's movement. After that, we will iteratively update the routing path in different iteration. So leader self will explore the new areas of the network, and followers will refine their routes to minimize delay and energy. So this optimization process will continue until the cells converge toward the optimal routing path. So when the stopping condition is satisfied, means the maximum number of iterations reached, algorithm will give us the best routing path found so far. So in the final result, we will get output as the best routing path. So here we have the leader self. So leader self will represent this best routing path that reduce the communication delay and minimize the energy uses of the sensor nodes. So this algorithm will explore different routes in your sensor network, and each self represent here a possible routing path, and best path is the path that has low delay and uses least energy. Then SSA will adjust the route over time, refine the choices until find the most effective path for the network. So that's all about this video. If you have any questions, you can comment below, and thanks for watching this video.